Praise the Lord, you reach Pastor Priscilla Holman. Let us go to the throne of grace. Eternal Heavenly Father, once again, you've proven yourself wise. Above all creation, now pour into the lives of those who need a word of wisdom regarding their finances. Show them how to become debt-free, how to have more than enough with what you've already provided for them. You can take little and multiply so that it will overflow and it'll be more than they could be hoping. Because you are God of creation and your ways work. Now it's a moment for financial teaching lessons, that you may change the financial stability of men. Take little and make much as you are glorified through the transition of what you do best. Able to create and bring into existence and ways we can't even think of. Because you are able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could ever ask or think of, according to the power that you have. You are the God of provision. And you shall supply all of our needs according to your riches. In Jesus' name we pray and give you the glory. Amen. 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 There is something about God when he teaches his people beyond understanding how to have a healthy relationship with him regarding money. You know that the Bible gives us several valuable lessons and towards how to have a healthy relationship with our money. The wisdom that God beholds, he gives us several scriptures that gives us wisdom. Because we live in a culture that tells us that the more we purchase and how much we pay for it, it's quite often more valuable and better. When God teaches us that he really wants us not to be heavy laden with debt, but he wants us to be free from debt so that we can live a life abundantly, so we have time for the things that are more important to us. We don't have to spend all our time laboring, not knowing about the economy. God teaches us how to be good stewards with what he gives us. And we are called to be content, but yet to be wise over what he has allowed us to have. Ecclesiastes 5:10 says, whoever loves money never has enough. To constantly seek after wealth is to have a spirit of unrest, where you make wealth more important than life itself. You'll never have enough. Always wanting, never satisfied. But Deuteronomy 8:18 tells us it is God who gives you the ability to produce wealth. But remember the Lord your God. For it is he who gives you the ability to produce wealth and so confirm his covenant, which he swore to your ancestors as it is today. Matthew 6:24 tells us that no one can serve God and money, for you either love one and hate the other. 1 Peter 5:2 tells us, don't be greedy for money. Learn how to appreciate and allow money to work for you. Don't extend yourself over in debt. Make a plan, an objective, to pay off one debt a month or a year and not continue to find yourself back in debt. Never allow your debt to extend, but so much. Put a cap, a realistic cap, that once you receive that cap, you won't continue to spend. Proverbs 15:27 says, whoever is greedy troubles household. Whoever is greedy for unjust gain troubles his own household, but he who hates bribes will live. God tells us how to properly steward what God has given us. The scripture reminds us that God ultimately owns everything here on earth. Our job is the responsibility to be stewards toward the resources that God has given us. We also have the opportunity to bring God's glory through the ways that we manage our finance. The Bible verses about managing finance, we can see various principles such as God blesses those who make money through honest work rather than dishonest practice. God calls us to pay back what we owe. We should never borrow what we don't have an intention to pay back. That is dishonest, and God doesn't bless that. It is always wise for us to have a plan, an objective, thinking through how we can make money and also how we spend our money so that it's honest gain, honest acquire of necessary things. Saving money is also part of God's plan for future financial success. Proverbs 13:11 tells us that dishonest money dwindles away. James 5:4-6 says to pay what you owe others. Don't borrow what you don't intend to pay back. A repetition that God uses throughout the Bible. Honesty. Proverbs 13:6 tells us to be wise, to think ahead, and don't brag about what you have. But be thankful and be good stewards over what God has given. Faithful over little, he'll make you faithful over much. Even with your finance. Luke 14:28 tells us to sit down and estimate the cost. Look at what you're spending. Look at what you're bringing in. Have a savings set aside for emergencies. And always have an objective to pay off, so that you'll have more left over. It is wise to store up wealth. Proverbs 30:24-25. Four things on earth are small, yet they are extremely wise. The ants are creatures of little strength, yet they store up their food in the summer. We can learn from the ants that stores up. We can store up our wealth on any time of the season. It's how we plan and how we view the money that God has given us stewardship over. Either we are unthankful and we are wasteful, or we are appreciative and we spend wisely. It's not always what you pay for an item that determines its wealth. A lot of times it's based on purchasing and finding the right price that requires time. The Bible even goes in further, teaches many things about being appreciative of what God has provided for us, that we should remember to provide for our household. But be not one of those who boast on the things that they have. Put up security. Plan ahead. Know what is necessary and unnecessary. And be very thankful and cautious of how you spend your funds. Remember to think of God. Don't be hard-hearted and tight-fisted, according to Deuteronomy 15:7. Remember to bless and remember, it's not always about receiving. For you never know the moment your funds may not be available. But God is able to restore. Think of others, even in your abundance, and even when you're trying to save and pay off debt. Remember that God is making these opportunities available for you. You are more than your paycheck. You are more than your job. You have been redeemed by a holy and righteous God who can get funds to you honestly any way he deems necessary. But always remember God in your purchases and in your giving. Know the moments of how to handle wealth, money management. Proverbs 3, 9 through 10 tells us to honor the Lord with your wealth. Honor the Lord with your wealth and from the first of all your produce, so your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will overflow with new wine. If you think about God and honor God with your money, he will continue to have a flow of funds coming in. You just won't know where it's coming from because he's the God of creation. It is a good thing to receive wealth from God. Ecclesiastes 5:19. The Bible says, and it is good thing to receive wealth from God and the good health to enjoy it, to enjoy your work and accept your lot in life. This is indeed a gift from God. Understand what is a gift from God. God gives the gift of health and the ability to prosper. Don't ever take that for advantage. Don't ever take it and fall for the devil's trap to give up your wealth and your health. Because the Bible says it is a good thing to receive wealth from God. He giveth wealth and he adds no sorrow to it. But remember the first fruit of what God has given you. Don't put your hope in the uncertainty of riches. According to 1 Timothy 6:17 through 19. For they can be here today and gone tomorrow. You are more than your paycheck. You are more than your savings and bank account. You are more than your portfolio of financial wealth. And remember, in the Bible, there are many accounts of God providing for those who were in need. We see God provided food for Israel in the wilderness, for Elijah during a drought, for Samaria during a time of famine. We also see God providing money, healing, comfort, and protection. In times of need, we aren't promised that God will give us wealth and riches, but we see in these Bible verses about managing finances that God will supply the needs of his people. God will supply all of your needs, Philippians 4:19. And my God will supply all your needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Open your mouth wide and I will fill it, Psalms 81:10. I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt. Open your mouth and I will fill it. The Bible says to remind yourself who you praise, who you glorify, who you exalt. Speak. Whatever things are true and pure and honest and of a good report, the Bible says, speak those things. And remember, as God clothes the grass of the field, how much more will he clothe you? Luke 12, 28. When we approach money the right attitude, with the right attitude, and look to God's word as our source of guidance, we can learn to manage our finances in ways that bring God's glory. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. He giveth riches, and he adds no sorrow to them. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not toward your own understanding. At all times acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. It's impossible for you not to have anything that God has ordained for you, because it's impossible for God to fail in any areas of his life. You have to trust God beyond sight. You have to trust God beyond understanding. You have to trust God beyond people's expectations. You have to trust God that he is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all you can ever ask or think of, according to the power that worketh within you. He's a God of great wealth. And he can teach you how to manage little and multiply for greatness. He can teach you how to get out of debt. He can teach you how to purchase a home and purchase other things without being in great debt. He can teach you how to live abundantly without stress or concern, because you understand that your finances can be managed, can be controlled, your debt can be handled by a holy and righteous God. It's how we view money and how we honor what God has given us. We have to see our finances, our resources, as coming from God and not institutions and companies. We have to appreciate what God has placed before us, to be thankful and ask him, how do we navigate through life's journey with what he has allowed? Abraham had little when God told him to leave Mesopotamia and go to a place where he would make him wealthy and give him a name, a great name. By faith, Abraham journeyed, not for the riches, but for the obedience of God. We have to journey and navigate through life within the obedience of God, and he will bring the increase. He's never not provided for his people. We have to be sensitive to God's providing and sensitive to how we appreciate what he has given. If he had Pharaoh to give his people an abundance of finance, of wealth to take with them that they owed them, he said, I'll take from the unrighteous and give to the righteous. That's what God can do. Anytime, anyway. If he said he would do that, then how much more would he do it for you now? The same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. He's a spirit. He's not moved by your colors. He's not moved by your gender. He's not moved by your abilities. He's not moved by your location. He's not moved by your knowledge. He's not moved by anything you can do. He has supernatural ability to create. And he has the ability to show himself strong and mighty on your behalf. A stock market could crash today, and God can still provide. The economy can turn upside down today. And God can still provide abundance, even in areas that are lacking. That's the God that he is. He can show you how to be faithful over little and make you faithful over much. Faithful over little funds, he will make you faithful over much funds. We have to see all that we have comes from God, which means first and foremost, we dedicate it to a holy and righteous God. The blood of Jesus Christ. Gives us the ability to overcome much. The blood of Jesus Christ brings us into a covenant relationship that makes us like hind feet to rise above our situation. The blood of Jesus Christ that brings us into his body. That no other blood will do. That no other powers could suffice. Gives us the ability to acquire wealth. His way. His righteous way. For he neither sleep nor slumber. This is a conference of biblical wisdom and how to manage money wisely and have a healthy relationship with money that God gives. Honest gain will provide honest provisions far beyond human imaginations. What a holy and righteous God that we have. Always remember, your resources is in him. He's your financial advisor. He is the one who ultimately writes your paychecks to provide according to his riches and glory. He is the risen Savior, the King of glory, that's strong and mighty in battle. Honor him with your income and watch him honor you with all that you do to honor him. Meditate on the Bible verses about managing your finances. Let him be your financial accountant. Let him be your financial headship to show you the biblical principles toward handling funds. And always remember, the love of money is the root of all evil. Don't love money more than your God. Don't pursue money over your God. Pursue him first and let all these things be added unto you. For he is your righteousness. He is the one that will never leave you nor forsake you. He is the one that will never make a mistake. He is your investor. He is the one that can increase beyond human imagination. Hold true to his writing. For in 1 Timothy 6,
according to Wikipedia, writing is a medium.
He has made it plain in all his ways about the love of money. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows because they love money more than the God of creation, who has the ability to make one wealthy, and he adds no sorrow to it. He that trusteth in his riches shall not be able to endure, shall not be able to endure the race, endure the life journey, shall not be able to stand in his presence with exceeding joy, shall not be able to be presented before a righteous and holy God, but the righteous shall flourish as a branch, because they trust him not in their riches, but they trust in the provisions and ways of a holy and righteous God. Don't seek the mammon, seek the holy and righteous God, as he prepared one to get out of debt and acquire the riches of the world, because he owns it all and he can control it all. He can shift the atmosphere in a twinkling of an eye to restore what the devourer had taken unrighteously. He can withhold the devourer from taking and bring righteous man in all areas of life. Behold, the righteous shall be recompensed in the earth, much more than the wicked and the unrighteous. The fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth soul is wise. The wisdom of the Lord hath spoken over finances that belong to God, for he owns it all, and he adds according to his will. Let us remember the God of creation that has the power to add wealth and the power to withhold. A God that is able. Let us go to the throne of grace. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, we thank you for being holy and righteous, pure and true, honorable and just in all your ways. For you have been good. You've been great. You've been faithful. You've provided abundantly. You've made wealth to come in areas seen and unseen, reserved for such a moment of your visitation. Because you are the God of creation. And your counsel shall stand. Your righteousness shall prevail. Because of who you are. A provider beyond imagination. Beyond what we can ask or think. Because your ways are not our ways and your thoughts are not our thoughts. And so, Father, we worship you. In the beauty of your holiness. Because you shall supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory, your righteous manner. Your will shall be done on earth as it is in heaven. Because we have acknowledged, we bow before the throne of grace to obtain, to obey, to receive, to appreciate and glorify who you are, the King of finances, the Lord of righteousness. In Jesus' name we pray and give you the glory for who you are. Oh, yes. Of who he is, the King of glory, the righteousness, who's strong and mighty in battle. Don't accept what God is not giving, because God knows what he's doing. Don't fall for deception. Receive what God is doing. Because humanity's plans shall not work without the plans and will of God. Knows what he's doing. You can't change God's will. You can't change God's ways. Humanity never will. God's word cannot be added nor taken from. He is the God of creation. a message of wisdom from a holy and righteous God. Ask God to handle wealth, because he's the giver of all wealth. Beyond human abilities, he's the God of wealth. And he determines who and how. He didn't give it to Lot, but Lot went with Abraham. Lot received the overflow because of Abraham. But when Lot came up against Abraham, God showed Lot who it was intended for in the first place. His relative could not take it. It's impossible to take from a holy and righteous God. He will have his statue to prevail. For those who trust in him, he shall fulfill his will. And no human can come up against a holy and righteous God and change nothing. And God has proven that as I speak. He controls, not humanity. He is the Lord of creation that has admonished us to do it his way and not our way. Abraham received because he obeyed by faith. God did not tell Abraham to take a relative that was reserved for Abraham's household. You cannot come up against a household and take what God is doing or has done. That is usurping your will over God's ordained plan and will. And so he showed Lot that he was just receiving the overflow. And he didn't appreciate the overflow. So he no longer received. And Abraham prospered and all that God had ordained for Abraham. In other words, what God has ordained for your life, no one can come up against it and change the course and plan of God. Because God will have the last say so. And he will show all what his ordained plan and will is and will always be. You can't change God's plan. Because of who he is. So you don't have to worry about colors. Because he's a spirit. Which means we don't change based on colors. We should be consistent in who we are because of his Holy Spirit that resides within these earthly vessels. That is the excellency of the power of God. Be not deceived by humanity's ways, but entreat, live and move and have your being according to God's knowledge, power, and will. Move. Receive in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, because he is the God of all wealth. Yalalapata. Yes, he is. And always will be. Thank you, Lord. 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 He teaches that some receive the overflow. But when you come up against the overflow that you received, you'll know who the intended outgoing always meant to be, that you can never change, because he's God and he's going to have his will, for he knows all things. His wisdom far excels people's wisdom. And I can rejoice in the message he just gave. A prophetic message about God's ability. That we have limited his power by having the audacity to think we can change anything. A holy and righteous God that shall always have his will when it's all said and done. Holiness is not your color. It's the condition, the state in which you are in him. It's the relationship you have established with him. It's the trust you have built upon his foundation. It's the understanding you have received from him. It's the knowledge he has imparted to you. And it's the wisdom he has shared abroad upon you, where you know beyond a reason of a doubt who's ultimately in control of everything. Don't ever underestimate a holy and righteous God. And don't ever limit God's abilities. Because he's faithful. Far beyond human imagination. It's impossible for God not to have his will executed. To say that is to say that he's not God. You either going to come to him and believe that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him, or you're going to believe that you can control the destiny, his plan of action. And that is impossible. Let no one debase God's ability. Amen. Amen. Amen.